Hello, my friends.
Greetings to all Hearthstone adepts.
Today we will talk about how to become a truly rich Hearthstone player without investment, and get a complete collection of only useful cards.
We will determine the number of packs needed to get a useful collection and discuss how to get it. In this video, you will also learn new facts about the economy of the game.
A year ago, in one of our videos, we talked about the possibility of getting a complete collection of cards for each expansion absolutely free.
We managed to establish that getting a complete collection of cards for even one single expansion is an incredibly difficult task. In addition to a huge amount of time and effort, you will need the help of a large number of friends, since you need to regularly receive invitations to complete the Play a Friend quest. But from a technical point of view, it is possible.
We often receive the question, how much does a collection of only the most useful cards cost? How much time do I need to spend? In this video, we decided to answer this question, as this topic is especially relevant on the eve of the release of Blizzard's Battle Pass. In addition, there have been some changes in the game's economy over the past year.
According to the promises of the developers, the new reward system that will be introduced along with the Battle Pass will hardly change the number of free resources. Therefore, if you are a viewer who is watching this video after the release of the Battle Pass, you have a good opportunity to compare the situation before and after the changes. Although we are confident that there will be no significant changes. Therefore, 90% of the information in this video will still be useful to you.
So where do we start?
Let's first determine the average amount of free resources that players receive during an expansion phase for playing activities.
As an example, we will take the number of free rewards received during the Descent of Dragons phase. Players had the opportunity to get 4,400 units of dust. This amount includes classic packs for winning the weekly tavern brawls and packs for completing quests, watch and learn, as well as packs of previous expansions that were received during events. For these calculations, all the previous packs are just dust. In addition, we have added to this value rare cards received as a reward for the monthly Diamond League achievement in competitive play. More than half of our viewers managed to achieve this result. In addition to dust, players receive approximately 26 packs per expansion, including packs from success in ranked and packs for watching official tournaments on Twitch. And also, in total, players received 7,400 gold for completing quests and as additional rewards for events.
The total value of all these awards is equivalent to 126 latest expansion packs. The amount of resources may differ in each expansion, but the total value is always about the same. This year, the average resource is slightly higher thanks to increased rewards for ranked play.
According to our forecasts, we will receive approximately this amount during Scholomance Academy. In addition, we will receive approximately the same amount after the release of the Battle Pass, or even a little more, at least developers say we will. But don't hope that there will be much more awards.
Knowing the number of free resources, let's determine the number of packs for the complete collection of cards as a whole.
At the beginning of this game year, players stopped receiving non-collectible duplicate cards in packs.
The community mistakenly thought that this should reduce the number of packs for the full collection. We stated that you need to buy 248 packs. The new data showed that our claim was wrong.
In fact, you need 262 packs to get a complete collection of cards of one expansion. Thus, the number of required packs has hardly changed.
Dear friends, forgive us for this mistake.
Guys, are you really mathematicians?
Dora, we demand to have a lawyer.
What's next?
Now let's determine the number of packs to get only the most useful cards. Provided that you get rid of useless legendary and epic cards.
Let's take the Scholomance Academy card statistics as an example. In the metagame, 17 out of 25 legendary cards are used. These cards have different popularities and effectiveness. Also, you will need 15 epic cards out of 23. Each card has 2 copies, so you need 30 epic cards. You will receive the complete collection of rare and common cards automatically after opening a little over 60 packs.
How many packs do we need to get all the useful cards?
You will need to purchase 212 packs to collect a complete collection of useful cards of one expansion.
This number is still very large. Thus, on average, a complete collection can be obtained by purchasing 262 packs, and for a collection of only useful cards, you need to purchase 50 packs less.
That's right, but don't forget about free resources.
So, 212 packs minus 126 packs as free rewards. We need to purchase 86 more packs. How do we find 8,600 gold coins?
It's very simple, Dora. We haven't talked about the final source of gold, daily wins. During the 120-day expansion phase, you need to earn a little more than 70 gold coins daily. For this you will need 21 wins per day.
How much time do I need to spend every day to achieve this result? That would take me forever.
It's not all that difficult, Dora. First, you need to find the most effective and aggressive deck in the metagame. For example, Face Hunter has a win rate of almost 63%, which means you need to play 34 games to get 21 wins. On average, a match lasts just under 6 minutes. This means you will need to spend 3 hours and 20 minutes daily to earn 70 gold. But don't forget, the World Health Organization of Azeroth warns, excessive use of the Face Hunter deck can damage your mental health.
Is there a faster way to make gold?
We found another way especially for you, Dora. You just need to sell your soul to demons and use the Discard Warlock deck in wild mode.
This deck has a slightly higher win rate and is a bit faster. In this case, you will need to fight 31 battles and spend 2.5 hours to get 70 gold coins. Even so, you will have to spend a total of 12.5 days in the game during the 4-month expansion phase. But remember, if you choose a slower deck with a lower win rate, the amount of time required can double or even triple.
I don't want to sell my soul to demons and waste so much time. By the way, my time is very valuable. Are there any other ways?
Yes, you can pre-order the new expansion for $50. If you reach the Diamond League every month and win 6 duels a day, one small pre-order is guaranteed to be enough for a collection of useful cards in one expansion. It is also a developer support tool.
If you don't want to put in the effort at all in a ranked game, then you need to invest $80 for a more expensive pre-order. If you don't want to put extra effort, but you want the entire collection, then you need 2 pre-orders for $130. To be honest, I am fascinated by the magic of numbers in Hearthstone, since every free resource, every special offer, every element of the economy is not random. Everything is very carefully calculated and is in a certain balance.
Let's draw some conclusions.
First, you can get most effective decks with little effort if you use resources very efficiently over a long period of time. You don't need to farm for this, you just need to pick up all possible rewards and make a couple of wins a day. If you are interested in a collection of extremely effective cards with a positive win rate, you won't have to spend as much time grinding. In the case that you have around 4 classes that you prefer to play, it will be enough for you to spend time in the game every day exclusively for your own pleasure, and you can get almost all new cards for these classes on the day of the release and immediately use most strategies.
Unfortunately, new players still do not even have a theoretical opportunity to get the full collection of cards of all expansions for free. It will take them over a year to catch up with players in standard mode in terms of their number of cards.
Some players use the same deck in wild mode throughout the year and they don't need any collection of cards at all. Efficiency in the game is completely free, but the fun can cost a lot of time and money.
It all depends on what style of play you prefer. But in any case, the more cards players have, the more extensive choice of strategies they have.
In this case, even if you are tired of a certain archetype or class in general, you have a huge number of other options. If you lose to an imbalanced deck, this is not a reason to delete the game, it is an excuse to build the same deck as your opponent, and thus speed up the nerf. Any changes to the balance in the game will not have negative consequences for you if you have a large collection of cards.
The Hearthstone economy has never been friendly, and may never be, but even in the current environment, you can get the most benefits if you use your resources correctly.
Finally, we would like to invite you to take part in an interesting discussion. A week ago, Hearthstone designer Dean Ayala tweeted the question, "If Hearthstone used to be your main game but isn't anymore, what would get you back?" In the last video we have already discussed the main disadvantages of the game, but maybe there is something else that could make the game better. Feel free to leave even the craziest ideas in the comments. We read all the comments as always.
We also invite you to take part in our new survey. How much gold do you have? Go to our community page and leave your vote. Also share your answer in the comments for more accurate data.
We would like to express our boundless gratitude to our sponsors. Guys, your support is incredibly important to us. Many thanks to each of you.
Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for being with us.
And special thanks to Chris for text editing.
We will meet in new videos.
Good luck.
eyes, good job. You have become more confident on camera.
Really? I think we are too static.
I am haunted by one question. Why are you using free resource data during the Descent of Dragon expansion and not Ashes of Outland? Do you have insufficient recent data?
No, that's not the point. The developers significantly reduced the number of free rewards during the Ashes of Outland expansion. In our opinion, the reason for the reduction was the emergence of one-off rewards for reaching ranks. Thus, in order to receive the same number of free rewards, we had to additionally play ranked, although during other phases we just had to go into the game and collect event rewards.
Wait, but the developers told us that the one-time rewards made the game more friendly.
Dora, this is a topic of a separate video.
Of course it's the right way.